Okay. So next, we have what's finished with the analysis of vectors. Our next topic is coordinate systems. So this is what's another important topic, which I can say, to analyze the various words or expressions related to our fields. So basically, we said that field is having what's a, if I say vector field, for example, vector field has got certain magnitude and direction. So it is distributed, what's a, throughout certain area with certain magnitude and having certain direction. The best example, if we consider gravitational field on the what's a, Earth surface. When you look at the gravitational field, so definitely it's a vector field. The gravitational what's a field will vary from place to place, but always the direction is also pointing towards Earth. That means a vector field we have to analyze with respect to what's a direction. So means the analysis of those vector fields becomes simpler, becomes easy, and what's a, if you have the knowledge of the coordinate systems. So basically, sir, the coordinate system will give a reference directions to the field. Some reference directions, what's a, to the what vector field. Here, as a part of the coordinate system, we have what's a, three types or three categories. The number one, which you are very much familiar as a part of your what's a, previous classes. Maybe we have seen about what's a two-dimensional, but we'll be talking about three-dimensional because a field can expand in all direction. Means normally everything in our real life, sir, we can visualize it as a 3D quantity. So that is why, okay, so means everything, whatever the coordinate system we are seeing with respect to the three-dimensional. So the first one here we say is rectangular, or Cartesian coordinate system. Second one, cylindrical, or circular, anything you can say. Cylindrical or polar. Cylindrical or polar coordinate system. The third one, spherical coordinate system. Right. So these are the three, what's the standard coordinate systems which we have to discuss, with which, okay, the different field what topics we'll be analyzing, so based on these coordinate systems. So first, let's begin with the concept of what's our rectangular coordinate system. Let's, okay, start with the rectangular coordinate system. When you just begin with what's a rectangular coordinate system, or Cartesian coordinate system. So basically, I think as a part of the two-dimensional, you know what we know, means always we analyze about there is some x-axis and there is y-axis. X and y axis, which are perpendicular to each other. Any two-dimensional quantity can be analyzed with respect to this two-dimensional Cartesian coordinate system. But now we are talking about field, okay? A field's canvas are expanded in all direction. So that we are analyzing with respect to three-dimensional quantity. So when we consider rectangular Cartesian coordinate system, okay? We have the same coordinates as what we know means in our previous classes like x and y, but the one more what's a coordinate extra we introduce here. So we say the coordinates of our rectangular coordinate system are x, y, and z. So it means this can be represented using the three coordinate axes which are perpendicular to each other. So I'm just indicating, let us say this as our x-axis, and this is our our y-axis, this is our z. This type of indication is called right-handed representation of our coordinate system. Right-handed representation of our coordinate system, x, y, and z. So where the three coordinate axes are perpendicular to each other. Okay? So and the coordinates, how do you mention? X, comma, y, comma, z. X, comma, y, comma, z. So first, sir, means before we analyze this, means there's a small question for you. That how do you indicate, sir, a point x1, y1 in a two-dimensional coordinate system? How do you indicate a point x1, comma, y1 in a two-dimensional coordinate system? Let's say this is x and this is y. So normally, let's say, sir, this is a point here, x1, comma, y1. To locate this point, one has to move x1 units along x direction. Let's say this is a point x1. And similarly, from that point, one has to move y1 units along y direction. Let's say, sir, these are the y1. Then, x1, comma, y1 point is located. So now, means this point, you can say x1, comma, made up of the coordinates x1, comma, y1. Similarly, how do we locate a point? Let's consider x1, comma, y1, comma, z1. X1, comma, y1, comma, z1 in a three-dimensional, rectangular coordinate system. For that also, we follow the similar procedure. What is the similar procedure? That means one has to travel along x direction, x1 units. And from that point, one has to travel along y direction, how many units? Y1 units. And from that point, again, one has to travel along z direction, that is nothing but z1 units. Z1 units. Then that point becomes x1, y1, z1 in a three-dimensional coordinate system. So for that, let us say I'm just traveling along x direction as x1 units. Let's assume this is x1 units. And from this point, let's say we are traveling for y1 units, let's assume, along y direction. And similarly, from this point, let's say we are traveling along z1 units. Now this point here, you can call it as x1, comma, y1, comma, z1. So that's how, sir, a point can be located in a three-dimensional Cartesian coordinate system. X1, comma, y1, comma, z1. So it's very simple, it's nothing new. Okay? This is similar to our two-dimensional coordinate system. But what is important with respect to this coordinate system, especially with respect to our EMT subject? So when you consider that, we just taken to represent a three-dimensional field, a three-dimensional representation of the coordinate system we have taken, like x, y, and z. Now, I'm just assuming, sir, the unit vectors along x direction as ax bar, and the unit vector along y direction as ay bar, and the unit vector along z direction as az bar. Okay, az bar. Now, we have to define an important parameter called what are the differential length elements? What are the differential surface elements? What are the differential volume elements? Okay, with respect to this rectangular coordinate system. So when we consider the differential length elements, differential length element. So the differential length means it is a smallest length along any one direction. Along any one direction. That means suppose if we consider this is our three-dimensional coordinate system called x, y, z. I can call it as a differential length along x direction. Smallest part of this x coordinate axis, I'm calling differential length along x direction. Similarly, I can say differential length along y direction. Similarly, this I can call differential length element along z direction. So these are called differential length elements. Differential length elements. So how do we write, sir, in terms of their coordinates? Because this is x coordinate axis, this is y coordinate axis, and this is z coordinate axis. The differential length element along x direction. Okay, the differential length along x direction. Let us consider the smallest part, the smallest length as dx, and what's it's along x direction. The smallest part, let's say it's dy. The smallest part, let's say dz, and the unit vector along this is ay. The unit vector along this is az bar. Then the differential length along x can be written as dx ax bar. That okay? Differential length element along x direction. You can call it what's a dx ax bar. So that indicates what is the magnitude of the differential length and what is that unit vector along that direction. Similarly, the differential length along y direction. The differential length along y direction is equals here, you say dy into ay bar. Dy into ay bar. The differential length along z direction is equals dz into az bar. Dz into az bar. So that's also we can simply understand what is the differential length elements along x, y, z. Sir, what is the significance of this differential length elements or differential surface elements or differential volume elements with respect to any coordinate system? Very simple. So whenever we go forward, sir, this differential length elements or differential surface elements, especially with respect to the charge distribution, when you consider a point charge has no dimension, which is just confined to a point. But when a charge is present throughout the length of a line, when the charge is present throughout the what's a length of a surface, let us say charge is present like this. Assume, let's say, if you know charge distribution in a small area, and if you want to evaluate the total charge present in this what's a total line. Similarly, let's say there is a surface, and if you know some elemental surface area, whatever the charge present here, there's a differential surface having what's a differential charge. From this, we can estimate what is the total charge which can be present on this surface. And means from this differential length element, if you know the charge present on this differential length element, we can evaluate the total charge present throughout the length of this line. Similarly, with respect to what's a differential volume. That means whenever we consider charge distribution, if we know the charge distribution throughout a small length or throughout a small surface or throughout a small volume, it is possible to evaluate the total charge present along the length of a line, or the total charge present throughout what's a length of a surface, throughout the surface area or throughout a volume, using the concepts of what's a differential length elements or differential surface elements or differential volume elements. That is why we are defining the differential length and surface and volume elements for each and every what's a coordinate system. Coordinate system. So with respect to or what's a Cartesian, it's very simple to understand what is the differential length element along x direction, differential length along y, and differential length along z direction. Similarly, what is the differential length element? What is the differential length element overall with respect to the Cartesian coordinate system? Means you can say it is what's a the vector sum of or the algebraic vector sum of all these three what's the components along x, y, and z, which gives the differential length element of our Cartesian coordinate system. Means the differential length element, you can just write sum of all these two, dx ax bar plus dy ay bar plus dz az bar. Dz az bar is the differential length element of this entire Cartesian coordinate system. Very simple, okay? Cartesian coordinate system. Similarly, now let us consider, sir, a differential surface which can be framed from this three-dimensional Cartesian coordinate system. In general, a surface can be made up of what's a two sides. So here we have three coordinates called x, y, z. That how many surfaces are possible? There are three surfaces are possible between all combinations of x, y, z. That is, there can be one surface called xy surface. I have understood. The surface made up of x and y coordinates, a two-dimensional surface. Similarly, a surface made up of what's a y and z coordinates. And similarly, a surface made up of here x and z coordinates. X and z coordinates. So now let us see what are the differential surface elements, okay, related to this xy, What are the differential surface elements related to this yz? The differential surface elements related to xz. Xz. Normally, because we know the surface is made up of what, sir? Two sides. Two sides are two dimensional. That means a surface along xy, how do we write, sir? It is? It is a product of differential length elements along x and y. Similarly, a surface area which is what, sir? Related to yz can be obtained by multiplying what, sir? Means the lengths along y and z. Similarly, the surface area along xz can be obtained by multiplying the lengths along x and z. X and z. That means whenever we multiply the length elements along the two dimensions or along the two coordinates, let us see, okay, how does the differential surface can be obtained. The differential surface can be obtained. So now I am taking a differential surface, okay, along xy direction. Or the differential surface made up of what, sir? X and y coordinates. But just now I said a differential surface along xy coordinates is simply equals to what, sir? Means a differential length along x. It's a product of differential length along x and the differential length along y. But just now we obtained that the differential lengths are the vector terms along x, y, and along y, and along z. That means here you can say ds xy is nothing but the differential length along x into the differential length along y. Because these two are vectors, the differential length elements are vectors. That means, so basically when we multiply, now there is a question that we have to consider either dot product or cross product. That means when there is a, what's the ambiguity that whether we have to consider dot product or cross product, let us analyze, sir, what happens for both the cases. Suppose let us say if I consider this product as a, what's a dot product. Dot product. Now you tell me what is the differential length along x direction becomes here. It will be what's a dx into ax bar dot dy into ay bar. Means when you apply this, what's a dot product for this to obtain a differential surface made up of x and y coordinates, but definitely we know that ax bar and ay bar are perpendicular to each other. Because they are perpendicular to each other, the dot product between them becomes what? Zero. That means there is no existence of differential surface. There is no existence of differential surface if you consider the dot product between the, what's it, two length elements. So that is why, but there is some finite surface we have made up of x and y coordinates. So definitely whenever we go for the differential surface elements, we have to consider the cross product between the differential length elements which are making that surface. Which are making that surface. Otherwise, there is no existence of what's a differential surface. But definitely, there is certain surface exists because of xy what coordinates. There is certain surface exists because of y and z. There is certain surface exists because of x and z. So we have to also means consider always the cross product between the differential length elements when we are evaluating a differential surface. So now whatever what's I have taken is definitely what's a will means produce a differential surface zero. So now I am just considering what's a the cross product between them. Cross product between them. So now let us see what happens when we all consider the cross product between them. Nothing but the differential surface made up of x and y coordinates means nothing but product of the differential length element along x and the differential length element along y. So what is the differential length element along x becomes here dx ax bar cross dy ay bar. Dx ax bar cross dy ay bar. So when you multiply the two vectors, so we know that normally, sir, their magnitudes are directly multiplied. That means we get what here? Dx dy and ax bar cross ay bar. So what is this? Ax bar cross ay bar will produce. Ax bar cross ay bar will produce a unit vector which is perpendicular to x and y. So what is the unit vector which is perpendicular to x and y becomes along z direction. So it is now indicated as dx dy into az bar. dx dy into az bar is nothing but the differential surface made up of x and y coordinates, but that surface direction will be along z direction. So it is also indicated as ds z bar. The differential surface along z direction will be what, sir? Will be made up of our x and y differential length elements, but its direction will be along z. Along z. Similarly, we can what, sir? Define the other differential surface, okay, elements made up of the other coordinates. So next one, suppose if we consider the differential surface along yz, the differential surface along yz will be definitely along which direction, sir? Means a normal, which is perpendicular, means a vector which is perpendicular to y and z. Nothing but what you can say it as, is the differential surface along x direction it becomes. Differential surface along x direction it becomes. Nothing but it is a product of, how do you say, the differential length elements along, okay, y and z, and a unit vector which is perpendicular to both, nothing but along x direction, which is called dy dz into ax bar. Dy dz into ax bar. Similarly, a differential surface along xz direction. Differential surface along xz direction. How you will be getting, sir? Or z, nothing but differential surface along y direction. Differential surface made up of x and z coordinates, nothing but differential surface along y direction. So dsy, you can say, a differential surface along y direction is nothing but what, sir? It is made up of dx and dz, and it is what, sir? It's the unit vector is perpendicular to all of them. So that's how we can see the differential surface elements. Differential surface elements along x direction, along y direction, and along z direction. That means from this we can understand that the differential surface always have a convention that the differential surface into unit normal to that surface. That means you can say any differential surface, sir, ds bar is equals ds into an bar. Ds into an bar, where an bar is a unit normal to that surface. Unit normal to that surface. That means differential surface is also a vector quantity. Differential length elements also what's a vector terms. Similarly, now let us obtain a what's a differential volume. A differential volume means a three-dimensional volume, let us say. When you consider differential volume, there is no doubt that the volume is made up of what's a the three coordinates. That means along x, along y, and along z will produce a three-dimensional figure. It's nothing but a volume. But when you consider the same concept for a volume, let us try to understand. When you consider the same concept for a volume, that means definitely that is made up of the differential length elements. So the differential volume element for the rectangular coordinate system, what you can say, product of differential length element and differential surface element, so differential length element along x, y, and z. So product of differential length elements along x, y, and z, what it will produce? That means our dx ax bar into dy ay bar into dz az bar. Definitely, if it is dot product, what it becomes? The volume cannot exist because they are perpendicular. And similarly, if you take cross product, sir, we have taken our representation itself is three-dimensional, but ax bar cross ay bar cross az bar becomes what, sir? Ax bar cross ay bar cross az bar means, as per the cross product formula, differential volume is dx, dy, and dz. So ax bar cross ay bar cross az bar. But we know that the cross product of this ax bar and ay bar becomes what here, sir? They'll become az bar. And the other one also what becomes here? Az bar and az bar. So when you consider, what, sir, the cross product between az bar and az bar is again what it is becoming, az bar and az bar, again we have a cross product between them. When there is a cross product between az bar and az bar, the angle between them is 0. As per that, what is the sign 0 becomes here? It becomes 0. What is the sign 0 becomes here, sir? 0. So that is why, what we can say, when you consider the dot product or cross product, what is the differential value we are getting, sir? 0. So that is why, instead of taking the differential what volume as a vector quantity, instead of taking term vector, sir, we'll be just taking it as a scalar. Definitely there is certain volume existing based on our what, sir? the three dimensional coordinates x, y, and z. Three-dimensional coordinates based on x, y, and z. So, because there is certain volume based on x, y, and z, you cannot say that the volume is always zero whether you consider dot product or cross product. So that is why instead of taking it as a vector representation, sir, the differential volume can be always taken as a scalar.